But it's the same base emotion of despair, but they refuse to go under. And the way they refuse to go under is laughing about it. And, you know, it's the most extraordinary coping mechanism.
Did the script for The Full Monty involve stories personal to you?
A lot of those characters are based on people I knew. Either I worked in a machine tools cleaning shop in Leeds, and some of the characters were based on people I met there. Some of them go right back to school days. When you start out writing, you tend to draw on a very close circle of people, because in a way, when you're an inexperienced writer, you sort of have to do that. So you're drawing on very, very near material, really. So yeah, it's a very personal script to me.
Did being involved with The Full Monty feel like a risk?
There's a misconception that the comedies are a hoot. You know, when you're on the set of a comedy, it's great fun to be there, everyone's having a laugh. Actually, it's terrifying for actors, I think. On a serious drama, if it doesn't work at the box office, if people don't like it so much, you know, they can admire the cinematography, they can admire the dresses, the set. There's many levels on which those things can work on, even if the film overall doesn't quite sing. But in a comedy, if it's not funny, you're dead in the water. There's nowhere to hide. And what's more, if it's a comedy that isn't funny and you stand there naked, I mean, you are in a tremendously humiliating position. If you do the big reveal and an audience all sit there, go, uh-huh. I mean, there can be not much greater humiliation than that. If they all stand up and roar with applause and go, fantastic, then you're fine.